this. You can see this arm, not alone, do I push the best part of the rod forward. I don't use this part now because I transfer it forward. But another thing is also the top of the rod dives. And when the top of the rod dives, the line follows the top of the rod, that means I'm going to have a big loop coming out. So this is a very bad movement to do, both for single hand and for double hand too. The top of the rod, the line always falls to the top of the rod. If I put the line on the top of the rod down, look, the line goes down. If I keep the top of the rod up, I'll have a small loop coming out high. That means this line is going to fly way further when I'm doing this movement here. So the cast we actually start doing it with the underhand. I think that's why they use the expression behind the cast. I don't think it's not anything to do with that. But by casting with more power, lower hand here, you can actually use more part of this, more thick part of the rod. You can see when I do this to a rod, then nothing happens. I can do this a lot. And you have absolutely no power in that arm, no matter how hard you do it. But as soon as you do this, so then the rod starts flying. The arm will start moving now, and let's do this movement here. Because this is actually where you bend the rod, and the fire starts coming out. So the way I divide this is actually right arm, left arm is this. The same thing is because you get a single hand rod, then the right arm is a technique that holds the rod, and the left arm is the one that's actually creating the energy. Same thing with double hand. So when I cast
them, saying right arm?
Right arm is technique, because that's the one that's actually controlling the rod. You see, when I start, you know, moving this one here, this is one that controls the top of the rod, it controls the way the reed comes around. So I have to like use this arm only to stop the rod, to lift the line off, to bring the rod back here. But every time I do an energy, put energy into it, I do it with my left arm. There. That's where energy comes. Yeah. So what I'm doing is, when I'm doing this cast, is actually I'm lifting and bringing the line off the water with my right arm. I'm bringing the line back here, putting the lead on the water, and then I'm casting out with my left arm. So right arm has nothing to do with the actual cast, it's just lifting it off, but the lift is bringing the line out all the time. Lift, there, brings it out. Right, lifts it up, brings it back. Left brings it up, and it uses very little energy. See, I can do a line like this with just one finger. Putting one finger on this right here, just hold it very slow here, and put this line up. And that's where all the energy is. It's actually because I'm using this part here right now. And I'm not using that part up there. And now, then we should start practicing lifting it off the water. And what we have to do, we have to get the line back so we have this D build up. You can see the D I build every time we make a back cast. See how this D is it? There it is. And then I go out. And if this D is standing like this, then I'll have a nice forward cast. If this D is like placed like this, it's going to be bad. If the D is not even touching the ground, it's going to be even worse. So this is all about timing with the right arm. When I'm using the right arm here, I'm lifting off the line off the wall. And as soon as I come to this point here, I start swinging the rod around. At this point here, the top of the rod must never dive. As I said before, the line follows the top of the rod. So if the top of the rod dives, the line is going to dive. And I see a lot of people lifting like this, and then they come up here, and then they decide that they're going to bring this back, and they're going to hit in the water. Then they take the top up like this, and then bring it up like this. And then you can see how this is landing here. And of course, it's going to release the same way. So if you bring the top of the rod up and take the top of the rod down, you're going to have this every time you land here. That's not good. What you want to do is you want to lift it up, and at this point here, the top of the rod only goes up, up, up. Can you see that? It's the leader that's going to come back and wrap the surface here. You have a straight lead on the water, and then you can choose the angle. You're going to cast it there, there, there. It's all about you, how you want to do it. So the setup is actually the most important part. That's also where the line is very important to have cut the right way, because if the lines are too long, if it's like a very long belly, it's going to be very hard to put this up, and you're going to use all this space behind you. If you have a short belly, it's much, much easier. It has to have a certain bit of width there, and bring it out there.